Welcome my dear students of class 9A and 9B to my history class. Today's points I am mentioning you. First of all, you open at page number 95. Open at page 95. Lesson number 3, page number 95. Open at page 95. You see, here are certain points. I am going to explain it from there. First point, art and architecture. In my last class, I taught up to impact of education. Today, from this point, art and architecture onwards, I am going to teach this lesson. Art and architecture. My first point, art and architecture. You know, the contribution of Buddhism in the realm of religious development, growth and improvement, helped by a number of distinguished kings, emperors of India. Once they were impressed by the ideals, techniques, methods, teachings, preachings of Buddhism and dedicated their life for the noble cause and upliftment of this religious concept with these. Who were they? They were King Ajatasattu, King Ashoka, King Kanishka. They all contributed a lot for the upliftment of this religious concept Buddhism throughout not only India but throughout outside India. For example, Ashoka himself sent his children to Sri Lanka, Malaysia in order to preach the concept of Buddhism. As a result, a number of foreign travelers came to India to receive the knowledge of Buddhism from the university in Nalanda. Ashoka thought that Buddhism and its concept must be preserved with various art and architecture. In consultation with artists, architects, Ashoka, introduced stone cutting skills and cellistic of pillars. Rock cut architecture also was introduced during that period. These are seen at Maharashtra at Ajanta Ellora caves. Besides, they introduced frescoes and sculptures dating from the 2nd century CE. Buddhism also was inspired with various architectural achievements in the form of stupas, in the form of viharas, in the form of monasteries. The rock cut caves had two parts, Chaita and Vihara. Chaita and Vihara. Chaita was a hall of worship. A Chaita hall was a rectangular hall with a semicircular ceiling. Long rows and pillars adorned the hall, while at the end of the hall there was a small chaita or stupa. Vihara was the monastery where the monks lived. Vihara were the monks where the monks lived. The earliest cave temples at the Chaita hall at Karle, Maharashtra, constructed at the beginning of the Christian era. The original woodwork is still in excellent condition. As soon as Lord Buddha died, Ajatasattu decided to preserve the body, remains of Lord Buddha, like teeth, his hair, his skin, his nails, etc. That's why he ordered his men to construct
a very important, to make an arrangement for preserving the realms of Buddhism, according to which Ashoka also followed the same system, and he himself constructed the famous stupa Sanchi. And in Sanchi stupa, he also made an arrangement of preserving the body parts of Lord Buddha. After the death of Lord Buddha, whatever body parts, whatever things he left, like nails, like all these things, these are duly preserved in Sanchi stupa. Nails, hairs of Lord Buddha after his death, these were collected from other sites, and these were kept into the these were collected and preserved inside the stupa Sanchi. It was constructed by Emperor Ashoka. And next, what is the meaning? What types of stupa, and what is the meaning of stupa? Stupa is one of the most prominent examples of Buddhism. Stupa is the most prominent examples of Buddhist architecture. It is actually largely dome-shaped architecture, contains relics of Buddha. Stupas are actually the relics of Lord Buddha. Buddha's hair, piece of calcified bone, tooth, and some order object of veneration. And this veneration, and some of the most famous stupas are, number one, Sanchi stupa, as I mentioned earlier. Sanchi stupa was constructed by Emperor Ashoka. It is constructed at Sanchi in Madhya Pradesh. In which year? In the 3rd century BCE, constructed by Ashoka at Sanchi in Madhya Pradesh in 3rd century BCE. It was a simple hemispherical brick structure built over the relics of the Buddha. It was crowned by the chakra, a pastoral-like structure symbolizing high rank, and artificially decorated all the pillars and some entrance. Many major entrances also are there, which attracts visitors to get inside the stupa. The Vedikas means railings, 4 Turanas means gateways, facing the four cardinal directions, as exquisitely carved with scenes and stories from the life of Lord Buddha. So these are done in Stupa Sanchi by Emperor Ashoka. Emperor Ashoka realized that its art and architecture would attract millions of people in the long run, which not only would increase the image of Buddhism, but also would increase the image of the Mauryans. As a Mauryan emperor, Ashoka wanted to communicate the image of the Mauryans also. That's why Ashoka drew worshippers, visitors from all over the world. And next one, Baharud Stupa. Another stupa's name is Baharud Stupa. Baharud Stupa was built during the Shunga period. The gateway of this stupa was decorated with exquisite sculptures. This is depicting scenes from the life of Buddha. The stupa is a dilapidated state now. Buddhas have a posture of standing, posture of sitting, Buddha posture of eating, posture of looking. Each and every part of his irregular activities are duly depicted, duly painted by the painters, artists, and these are depicted on the surface of the wall of this stupa. This is Baharu stupa. These were done by Sunga kings. Now, Dhammik stupa. King Ashoka built this cylindrical shaft stupa at Sarnath in Varanasi. King Ashoka, Dhammik stupa. At the spot where the Buddha gave his first sermon, historic sermon, to his five disciples after attaining enlightenment. That's why, in order to commemorate the image of Lord Buddha, he first took his first sermon, and there were five disciples in front of him sitting and hearing him, his advices, and and learning it quickly. This scene also is depicted in this Dhammik stupa, and King Ashoka, that idea also was found out by King Ashoka. That's why King Ashoka built this in cylindrical shape stupa at Sarnath, the place near Varanasi. And next one, Amaravati stupa. The stupa, Amaravati stupa, was built during the reign of Ashoka at Amaravati in Andhra Pradesh. Amaravati, it was decorated with carved panels which depict the story of Buddha's life. The stupa had a circular terrace with stairway, and the dome and railings are made of marble. Only remains of the stupa can be seen in museums. So Amaravati stupa was a stupa, you know, built during the period of Emperor Ashoka at Amaravati in Andhra Pradesh. It was decorated with carved panels which depict the story of Lord Buddha's life, and its stairway, its dome, its gateways, all types of things are the combination of its architecture attracts the people. All the railings are made of marble, attracts millions of people, and still these are the important religious spots, religious travelers, buildings usually come from outside and visit it. And next point, schools of architecture. The Mathura school, who introduced it? Who established the Mathura school? The Kalunga, the Kushana, The Kushana ruler Kanishka was a major patron of Buddhist art and architecture. Under his patronage, many images of Lord Buddha, many images of Lord Buddha were produced under his patronization. Under King Kushana, under his patronage, many images of Lord Buddha were produced. The Kushana school of art also was established under his patronization and under his patronage. The statues produced by the artist of Mathura family mainly portray the Buddha in a sitting yogic posture. Students of Mathura art school of art, they made this statue of Lord Buddha in a sitting mood of yogic posture. The facial features are a mix of flat Central Asian features and the roundness of the people of the subcontinent. Artists in Mathura use red sandstone. A fine example of Mathura school of art is the headless statue of Kanishka. Another magnificent statue is that of a standing Buddha which belongs to the 5th century CE. So these are the most important achievements of the Mathura School of Art and Paintings. Next, the Gandhara School. During the reign of Kushanas, a distinct art form evolved in the north subcontinent near modern-day Afghanistan. This style, known as the Gandhian school, influenced by Greek style, which is long, flowing robes and folds in the clothing. The angular feature resembling Greek gods like Apollo and are very realistic. Gandhara artists mainly grey sandstone. That's why Gandhara art and architecture also looks very, very attractive. Then next one, Sarnath School. Around the 5th century CE, excellent statues were produced at Sarnath. Sarnath is near Varanasi. And why is Sarnath important? Sarnath important because Lord Buddha's first sermon was at Sarnath near Varanasi. And famous of them is the seated Buddha. That's why they choose Sarnath to be an important historical site for the popularity of Lord Buddha's image. That's why they produced it at Sarnath, a seated Buddha made of sandstone with a smooth texture. And you know, Lord Buddha's, you know, seated in Padmasana, his hands in Dharmachakra Mudra, on his either side, eight two celestial figures. This is the specialty of the art and architecture of this Sarnath school. Beautifully decorated, all the scenes of the lives of Lord Buddha, beautiful sculptures depicting various stages of Buddha's life have been found at Amaravati and Nagarjunakonda. So the art and architecture of Buddhism inspired Hindus to create a religious art form for the first time, mantra reciting, nature worshipping Hindus began to create idols of their gods to install in their temples. The temples too changed from being simple open air structures to more elaborate temples complexes. That means the beautifully art and architecture and sculpture of the Sarnath school, you know, encouraged the Hindus. As a result, the Hindus began to create idols of their gods to install in their temples, which was not introduced by Lord Buddha, because Lord Buddha, you know, did not believe in the existence of God and was against installing of any idol worship inside the temple. Sarnath School of Sculpture encouraged a group of Hindu people or Hindu kings to make idol worshiping and to install their god and goddesses in their respective temples. And the temples too changed from being simple open air structure to more elaborate temple complexes. So that idea they came from where? From the Sarnath School of Art and Sarnath School of Art and Architecture and Paintings. Next day, a few more points also are left, and that will be completed. Then teaching of this lesson will come to these 5-2 rules. Thank you.